Hi friends, we'll discuss kinematics of particles. In kinematics of particles, rectilinear motion. Basically, in kinematics of particles, what we'll study here, two types of motions. First type of motion is rectilinear motion and second motion is curvilinear motion. In rectilinear motion, when any particle moves along a straight line, that may be horizontal, that may be vertical, when your particle moves along straight line, then the motion is called as rectilinear motion. In rectilinear motion, when particle moves along straight line, there are three possibilities. If particle moves with constant velocity along a straight line, then the motion is called as uniform motion. As velocity remains constant, that means acceleration of particle is zero. Therefore, first type of motion, A you can say, is uniform motion. Velocity remains constant. As velocity is constant, acceleration of particle is zero. Therefore, in uniform motion, as acceleration remains constant, from equations of motions, we will get only one equation for uniform motion, that is nothing but S equal to, or may be written as X if particle moves in horizontal direction, or may be written as y if particle moves in vertical direction, that is equal to u into t. Only one equation for uniform motion, which represents what? Product of velocity and time represents what? X or may be y or may be s. If during motion velocity doesn't remain constant, but when velocity varies with respect to time, that means dv by dt, and if this rate of increase of velocity with respect to time or rate of decrease of velocity with respect to time, if it is constant, that means when acceleration remains constant, then the motion is called as uniformly accelerated motion, which is nothing but second type of motion. Motion is called as uniformly accelerated, uniformly accelerated motion. In short, this motion is written as UAM. That means this is such a type of motion in which acceleration of particle remains constant. A is what? Constant. For this type of motion, equations of motions which are available, there are three. Three equations of motions we can apply for uniformly accelerated motion. First equation is nothing but V equal to U plus AT. This is equation number one, where V represents final velocity of particle, U represents initial velocity of particle, A represents acceleration, and T represents time in second. Second equation is V square equal to U square plus 2as, where S represents displacement, A is acceleration, V means final velocity, and U represents what? Initial velocity. Third equation is S equal to ut plus half at square, where S represents displacement. This is equation number 2, then equation number 3. S equal to ut plus half at square, where S is displacement, U is again initial velocity, A is acceleration, and T represents what? Time instant. At what time instant we'll find out the displacement. Now, acceleration remains constant, motion is uniformly accelerated motion. That means these three equations of motions, 1, 2, 3, are for uniformly accelerated motion. Third type of motion in which acceleration doesn't remain so constant, that means acceleration varies. Acceleration may vary with respect to time, acceleration may vary with respect to position, acceleration may vary with respect to velocity, then the motion is called as motion with variable acceleration, motion with variable acceleration. As motion is with variable acceleration, then our acceleration doesn't remains constant. Therefore, for this type of motion, these equations what we have written, equations 1, 2 and 3, these three equations are not valid. Then how we will get solution of these problems, that one we will see when we will discuss in detail motion with variable acceleration. Now three types of motions are there: uniform motion, second type is uniformly accelerated motion, third type of motion is motion with variable acceleration. Now in same uniform and uniformly accelerated motion, what is important, this meaning of this term is very important. That one is nothing but your displacement, which is given by S. If we'll assume particle moves along a straight line, say horizontal straight line, if we'll assume, will represent say one path where this path is horizontal straight line path, where if we'll assume this location is origin having coordinates as 0, 0 and particle moves in rightward direction. If particle moves in rightward direction, it passes through some points here, maybe point A, assuming some coordinates say 6, 0. Next one what will get here, point B, maybe this one is what 10, 0. One more location I will represent here, point C, maybe 15, 0, these are the coordinates. And one more location on left side of this origin, that means definitely coordinates are minus, that means x is negative, say minus 5 and 0. Just straight line path where motion starts from say origin and particle moves from O to in rightward direction, passes through some locations A, B, C, and then finally position D. How will reaches to position D? Just see here. First one, when motion starts from O, and if we'll analyze motion up to point A, from where particle starts its motion is considered as origin. Here particle starts from this origin O itself, therefore coordinates of point O is 0, 0. Therefore initial position is origin, final position is A. That means displacement of particle, if you want to find out when it moves from O to A, is final position minus initial position. So in this case final position is 6, initial position is 0. Therefore, if we'll consider motion from O to A, for this O to A motion, displacement is final position, that means x at point A minus x as point 0, that means origin, is nothing but 6 minus 0. What displacement will get is what, 6 meter. Displacement is always final position minus initial position. If we'll consider say motion from A to C, then A becomes initial position and location C is final position. Therefore, motion from A to C will analyze, then displacement becomes what? Position at this C minus position initial means at A, what it becomes, 15 minus 6, that means which comes out to be what? 9 meters. That means displacement simple, it is always final position minus initial position. If particle moves in rightward direction and it is subjected to say initial velocity u rightward positive and acceleration of particle if negative, what it represents, as particle proceeds in rightward direction along this path and is subjected to acceleration, that means velocity of particle gradually decreases. As velocity of particle gradually decreases, somewhere velocity of particle becomes 0 and then again velocity becomes negative. That means during motion particle reverses its direction of motion. If you will assume particle starts from O, moves in rightward direction up to A, B and at C it reverses its direction of motion, that means definitely at point C velocity of particle becomes 0. Velocity of particle when becomes 0 at point C, then it becomes negative. That means particle, say I will represent here slightly below this one, particle then moves in leftward direction. That means direction of motion reverses, but this one is possible only when particle is subjected to negative acceleration. That is very important. Now, if particle is subjected to negative acceleration, particle starts from O with initial velocity, moves in rightward direction, velocity gradually decreases, and when it reaches to say point C, it reverses its direction of motion. That means velocity of particle becomes zero. Now, if it again passes through point A, that means motion is from where to where? O, A, B, C and A. That means motion O, A, B, C and A. Here if you will find out what is the displacement, again final position minus initial position. Final position is what? To point A is x A. Again initial is what? 0. That means what will get? 6 minus 0 is nothing but what? 6 meter. Anyway, displacement is always final position minus initial position. Again, if it moves and then passes through point O, displacement becomes what? Final position 0, initial position 0, displacement is 0. If it continues its motion up to point D, now final position is minus 5, initial position is 0, that means displacement becomes what? Minus 5 meter. That means motion is from where? O, A, B, C, then again it reverses A, O and finally point D. If this one is a motion, then displacement that depends on only final and initial position. Final position means what? At D. Initial means what? At 0. That means what will get? Minus 5 minus 0. That means what displacement will get is minus 5 meter. Now see here, displacement may be positive. Displacement 0 is also possible when particle passes through again point O, and displacement negative also possible. That means displacement is a vector quantity and it is always final position minus initial position. If we will concentrate on distance travelled, so distance travelled is actual length of path travelled by particle during motion. For example, say O to C, what is the distance travelled? You can say O to C directly, you can see this one is 15, to 15 minus 0, that means we will get 15 meter. O to A motion, if we will consider, distance travelled is 6 minus 0, means 6 meter. O to B motion, if we will consider, distance travelled again, this one is 10, is 0, means 10 meter. Displacement and distance travelled remain same if particle continues its motion in same direction of initial motion. That means up to point C, displacement and distance travel will get same. Now, if particle changes its direction of motion, maybe if it say passes through what, this point A. Now, O, A, B, C and A. Now, if you want to find out distance travel, as a drawn figure, easily you can identify okay, from O, it moves up to C and then from C, it reverses and again passes through point A. That means this distance travel is 15. And then from 15 to this one is 6, that means what? 9 meter. That means from O to A motion, if you will consider, distance travelled is equal to this one, will add like this simple. Okay, this is 15 plus this distance is what? 9 meter. That means distance travelled is for 24 meter, which is different than displacement. From this one, what is the conclusion? If particle continues its motion in same direction, displacement and distance travelled are same. If during motion particle changes its direction of motion, then displacement and distance travelled are different. Now, most interesting part is what? How will find out? Here when you are represented this path, then it's easy to identify 15 plus 9. But such path is never given in problem. Some equation is given, initial velocity is known, acceleration is given, then how will find out this one? So 15 meters and 9 meter, these are nothing but displacements. I mean, displacement from where to where? So in same direction, first displacement is 15 minus 0, means 15, and next one is what? From C to A, displacement becomes final 6 minus initial 15, means minus 9 meter, and you are adding without considering their sign. Then while solving problem, what you have to do, say any time interval is given. Now from when particle moves from O to A, B, C and again A, say total time what it takes कि डेल्टा टी इज से 15 सेकंड, दिस वन फॉर एग्जांपल 15 सेकंड. नाउ दिस 15 सेकंड विल डिवाइड इन टू टाइम इंटरवल्स, बट टू डिवाइड दिस इन टू टाइम इंटरवल सम टाइम इंस्टेंट विल फाइंड आउट वेयर दिस वेलोसिटी ऑफ पार्टिकल बिकम जीरो. दिस वन विल गेट इक्वेटिंग दिस वी टू जीरो यूजिंग इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन वी इक्वल टू यू प्लस ए टी. इफ विल अज्यूम यू इज सम 10, एक्सीलरेशन इज -1, तो टाइम इंस्टेंट मे बी बिकम्स वॉट 10 सेकंड. इफ विल अज्यूम 10, यू इज 10, एक्सीलरेशन नेगेटिव से -1 एंड टी, दैट मीन्स टी कम्स आउट टू बी वॉट 10 सेकंड. दैट मीन्स एनी हाउ यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट दिस टाइम इंस्टेंट एंड विच वन इज इजिली विल गेट इफ विल इक्वेट फाइनल वेलोसिटी ऑफ पार्टिकल टू जीरो. वंस विल गेट दिस टाइम इंस्टेंट, नाउ 0 टू 15 सेकंड यू कैन से अप टू 10 सेकंड पार्टिकल मूव्स इन राइटवर्ड डायरेक्शन, देन फ्रॉम 10 टू 15 सेकंड पार्टिकल मूव्स इन रिवर्स डायरेक्शन. विल डिवाइड दिस टाइम इंटरवल इन टू पार्ट्स, 0 टू 10 सेकंड एंड 10 टू 15 सेकंड. इन दिस टाइम इंटरवल इफ यू फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज द डिस्प्लेसमेंट, इट इज एक्स एट 10 सेकंड इज 15, हियर इट इज 0, दैट मीन्स कम्स आउट टू बी 15 - 0. And in this time interval, displacement is final position means here at A, which is 6, and initial position at C means what? At t equal to 10 seconds, it is what? -15. That means what will get here? -9. Now, if we'll add these displacement without considering their sign, then what distance traveled will get is nothing but delta x1 plus delta x2. That means 15 plus 9 is what? 24. That means finally, distance traveled is mod of delta x1 plus a mod of delta x2. From this one, what is the final conclusion? Displacement is final position minus initial position. Displacement, if you want to find out, it is always final position minus initial position. Final position minus initial position. That means delta x is represented by delta x. Displacement is delta x. Final is x minus initial position is what? X0. If we will write this equation in vertical direction, may be written as delta y equal to final minus initial. That means y represents what? Final position. Y0 represents what? Initial position. Now, distance traveled is actual length of path traveled by particle during motion. Actual length of path traveled by particle during motion is what distance traveled. So what is the method to find out distance traveled? As we discussed, first step is what? Find time instant at which particle reverses its direction of motion. First, find time instant at which particle reverses its direction of motion by equating its velocity to 0. By equating its velocity to 0 using equation. Which equation? Using equation v equal to u plus a t, and we will equate it to 0. This one is first step. Once we will get this time instant, then what we will do? Second step, divide given time interval in two time intervals. Divide given time interval in two time intervals. Next step, find, in third step, we'll find displacement in each time interval independently and add them without considering their sign. That means what? This distance traveled is equal to mod of delta x1 plus mod of delta x2. That means in this case finding the time instant is very important. Once we'll get time instant, then easily we'll get what? Distance traveled. So displacement is always final position minus initial position. Distance traveled is actual length of path traveled by particle during motion. Displacement is a vector quantity. Distance traveled always will get positive, and if it is independent of in what direction particle is moving, therefore distance traveled is scalar quantity. Therefore, rate of change of displacement with respect to time is called as velocity. Velocity is also vector, and distance traveled divided by time or per unit time is nothing but speed, which one is a scalar quantity. Once we will get this distance traveled and displacement, next important part is what? When particle moves along a straight line, maybe in horizontal or vertical direction, and number of bodies involved in problem one or maybe two, how will tackle problem? So concept of origin is very important. We'll discuss now concept of origin using this one. Solution of problem involving two bodies particularly becomes very easy. Now see, when any particle moves say along a straight line, see here, say this one is some vertical path I will represent. Now as motion is vertical, we will apply equations of motions where acceleration due to gravity always acts in downward direction. Therefore, equations of motion when we will write as per our sign convention, upward positive, downward negative, so A is replaced by minus G. Now, suppose this one is a ground, height we will assume some height as say 130 meters, this is height of tower, or maybe you can say some hill is given and then some bodies are thrown. In these problems, initially we will assume single body problem. In single body problem, when single body is involved in a problem, then a body may start from ground, maybe A, body may start from the top of a tower, from the top of a tower maybe body may be thrown in upward direction, may be thrown in downward direction. If single body is involved in problem, then the location from where body starts its motion is considered as origin. For example, if body is thrown from top of a tower at t equal to 0, that means this location will consider as origin, and the single body is thrown with some initial velocity. As it's a single body problem, from where body starts its motion is origin, that means aapka x axis is what? Rightward, y axis upward. Therefore, initial position with respect to origin becomes 0 for a single body problem. But finally, when body is thrown and then finally it strikes the ground, this is the final position. Now, final position you have to write with respect to origin. Origin is here at B, and now final position is below origin. Therefore, if you will write what is the final position with respect to origin, as it is below origin, we have to write with minus sign, and it is below origin at what distance? The minus 130 meters. That means for single body problem, the location from where body starts its motion is considered as origin. Therefore, for single body, y0 is always 0. And final position depends on where is the final position of particle with respect to origin. If final position is below origin, then y is negative. If final position is above origin, then y is positive. And we will start counting of time from where that particle starts its motion. Therefore, equations of motion always will get in terms of time equal to t second. Now, if two bodies are involved in a problem, particularly two body problem. If two bodies are involved, now one body is thrown say from B, another body is thrown from A. Say this one is what UA. Out of these two bodies, we have to identify which body starts its motion first. For example, if we'll assume first body B is thrown in upward direction, after 2 seconds body A is thrown in upward direction from ground. That means what is given? Body B is thrown from the top of a tower with some velocity UB. After 2 seconds body A is thrown from ground. That means first which body starts its motion? The body B starts its motion first. Therefore, for body B, that location will consider as origin. For body B, y0 becomes 0. Now, for body A, as it starts its motion from ground, to what y0 will get here, that is again with respect to origin, but which is below origin at a distance of 130, that means y0 of body A, second body, becomes negative. Now, once motion starts, y0 term is very important. Therefore, for one body y0 becomes 0, and y0 of second body, depending on its position, as it is below origin, so you will get what? Minus. If it is above origin, then we will get what? Positive value. Equations of motion for this body B will start counting of time from where first body started motion. So this one becomes what? T second. For second body, it starts its motion 2 seconds later. Therefore, here this second body travels in air for less time, that time is what? 2 seconds. Where this time 2 seconds is represented by T dash, where T dash is called as what? T dash is called as time lag. So this may be given in any problem. One body is thrown, after some time second body is thrown, so that time lag part is very important. Therefore, second body always takes less time to travel that particular distance, and finally this T minus T dash, if we'll use in equation of motion, then equating their positions, how will equate the position? Body B is thrown in upward direction, after 2 seconds body A is thrown, and these two bodies strikes somewhere. Say this one is body A and this one is a body B. That means what position you are getting, as both the bodies are at same location with respect to origin, final position, if you will see, this one is same. That means for body B as well as for body A, it is same. That means here, if you will see, this YB and YA, as they are below origin for both the bodies, what will get here? Minus answer is expected. Or if solving equation, if you will get negative answer, that means where they strikes, that location is below origin. If answer will get positive, that means two body strikes above origin. It means for two body problem, what is the conclusion? The location from where first body starts its motion is considered as origin. Therefore, for first body, y0 is 0, and for second body, we will find out its initial position with respect to origin. For first body, equations of motion are in terms of time equal to t second. For second body, equations of motion are in terms of t minus t dash second, where t dash is a time lag. When two bodies strikes each other, or car A overtakes car B, or maybe one train passes other or meets at some particular location, final position is same. Therefore, for final position for both the bodies, maybe along x axis, to xA equal to xB, if that is along y axis, yA equal to yB, equating this final position, easily we will get what? Solution of problem. Thank you.